So welcome back, dear friends. Now we are going to discuss here our topic, that is from homeopathy topic, metals and non-metals. Okay, so in metals and non-metals, we are going to discuss here, we already discussed some physical properties of metals, then we discuss chemical properties, their chemical properties, reactions of metals with oxygen. Okay, or we can say with air. Okay, so now it's time to move forward. Okay, so see here. Here one of the most important, that is your anodizing. Anodizing. So see here, what is meaning of anodizing? So what will happen here? First your aluminium develops a thin oxide layer. What will happen? First aluminium develops a thin L2O3 layer. Okay, when it reacts with oxygen. Okay, so after that, what will happen? This coat, whatever L2O3, this coat, it's what will happen? It's further. What is the meaning of this coat? This coat surfaces. They are doing resistant to corrosion. Okay, they are doing what? Further resistant to corrosion. Okay, so this, whatever this resistance, whatever this your oxide layer. Is further we can improve this whatever this Al2O3, this oxide layer, Al2O3 oxide layer, we can further improve by thick layer also. Okay, so this thick layer, how can you improve? So see here, how can we do this? Okay, suppose this was your aluminium. Okay, so here this aluminium metal we have to immerse in acid electrolyte solution. Okay, so after that, what will happen? Whatever there act as an anode. Okay, so this whatever oxide layer, so this aluminium, when you dipped into suppose H2SO4, dilute H2SO4 solution, And by passing electricity, it will again here, what will happen? Here oxide layer will develops. Okay, so we call it as a what? Thick oxide layer develops. Thick oxide layer develops. Understood? So first, so once again you see, when your aluminium first is what? Thin oxide layer develop, and whatever thin oxide layer is further improved by what? By whatever your Al2O3, your aluminium metal, again you have to dip in what? H2SO4. Okay, then it forms what? By passing electricity, it gives what? Your thick oxide layer. Understood? So these are what? Your anodizing. So like that we can what further corrosion we can stop of this aluminium. Okay, so now we will discuss here, what is the noble metals? Noble metals. So see here, in noble metals, okay, noble metals means what? These are simply, they are what? Resistant to corrosion or oxidation. They are what? Noble metal means what? They are resistant to corrosion or oxidation. Understood? These are what? Your noble metals. So examples, so many examples, as you know, our gold, then silver, then platinum, etc. These are what? Resistant to corrosion or oxidation. We call it as a what? Noble metal or non-reactive metals. Okay, so see here, now we will discuss next our term, that is base metal. Base metal. So see here, one more here important is term, So which are base metals? So these are what? Simply base metals means what? These are easily corroded by, okay, these are what? Easily oxidized or corroded by your concentrated HCl, or if you add water in that, so it becomes what? Dilute HCl. Easily corroded by your dilute HCl. Understood? So for example here so many examples in that, your iron, then nickel, then your lead. Okay, so here mostly importantly what? These are oxidized or corroded easily with a dilute HCl, means what? Base metals. Those metals which are corrodes or oxidized easily with what? Dilute HCl is called what? Base metals. So examples are what? Iron, nickel, lead, etc. Okay, now one more here, one exceptional case also there. Okay, so that exceptional case, see here, that exceptional case is what? Your copper. Exceptional case. Okay, so your copper. So this copper is act as a base metal, even though it does not react with HCl. It is one of the important here. Okay, exceptional case is what? Your copper, even though it does not react with HCl, then also what? It is act as a what? Your base metal. Okay, now see here, or we can say why it is, one more we can add here, because why it is exceptional case here, copper, it does not react with HCl, but it can corrode it. Okay, but it can what? Corrode it. So see here, our next, whatever our copper. Okay, see here, next we will say strategic metals. So these also very much important terms. Okay, so strategic metals. Okay, so say the metals of strategic means what? Metals of vital importance. Metals of vital importance. Or vital importance means we can say which metals that are used in defense ministry. Okay, so defense ministry, then whatever industry sectors. Okay, these are what? Your strategic metals metals used in your jet fuels. Okay, in space researches, so we call it as a what? Your strategic metals. So few examples also they gave here. In atomic plants also we can use this your strategic metals. So see examples here, then manganese, titanium. Okay, manganese, titanium, zirconium, etc. These are what? Your strategic metals. Understood? So we discuss here a few terms, okay, which are used in very much different criteria. Okay, so first we done anodizing. As you know, first aluminum develops your thin oxide layer, and it is further improved by what? Further improved by immersing that aluminum in your dilute HCl super solution, and by passing electricity, it will what will happen? It forms a thick oxide layer. Understood? So like that we can form as a corrosion. Okay, means resistant to corrosion we are applying on that. Okay, now say our next year, that is reaction of metals with water. See here, reactions of metals with water. Prior we saw reaction of metals with oxygen. Okay, so here very much important, what will happen when your metal reacts with water? Okay, so you concentrate on this, very much important. Okay, so we are divided into here two categories, like that we saw in activity series. Are you remembering that? Okay, KB Nath ka Mali, Alu Zara Fike, Crunchy Pakata Hai. Okay, Kaun Hai Aage, आओ पंताजी, अंडरस्टूड? सो इट इज व्हाट अवर एक्टिविटी सीरीज, और वी कैन से रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज फ्रॉम पोटेशियम टू प्लैटिनम. ओके, सो सी हियर, रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटल्स विथ वाटर. इन दैट वी आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कैटेगरी. दैट टू कैटेगरी इज व्हाट, यू आर अ हाईली रिएक्टिव मेटल एंड लेस रिएक्टिव मेटल. सो सी हियर, हाईली रिएक्टिव मेटल वी कैन से हियर, सी highly reactive metal. Okay, so once again, highly reactive metal, in highly reactive metal mostly, say highly reactive metal, what they are doing, metal plus water. Okay, highly reactive metal is what? Metal plus water, that gives what? Yes, metal hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Understood? And less reactive metal. Okay, so see here, less reactive metal is what here? Yes, metal plus water, that gives what? Yes, metal oxide plus what? Hydrogen gas. Understood? So very much important, these are, okay, you do box for this. Understood? Means highly reactive metal is what? Metal plus water, that is what? Metal hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. And less reactive metal is what? They are doing what? Metal plus water, that is what? Metal oxide plus hydrogen gas. So very much important is highly reactive metal, what they are giving, metal hydroxide they are giving, and less reactive metal they are giving what? Metal oxide they are giving when it reacts with what? Water. Okay, so these are important here. So from on the base of this, we are doing what? Reaction. Okay, so see, as you know one thing, okay, metals that are placed above hydrogen, it can displace hydrogen gas from dilute acid. Okay, understood? From it can displace what? Hydrogen gas from water and dilute acid, and whatever, okay, so whatever our below hydrogen, it can't displace hydrogen gas. Okay, this thing we saw in our reactivity series. Okay, so now we will discuss here some examples in that reaction of your metal with water. Okay, so see, reaction of metals with water, in that we will see here example as a sodium, okay, then potassium, then calcium. Okay, so see here, sodium plus water, yes, it is highly reactive metal. So what they are giving us is NaOH. Understood? Okay, NaOH plus what? Yes, H2 gas they are giving us. Means 1 Na, 1 Na, H2. So see here, 2 Na. See our reaction balance or not. 2 Na, yes, here also 2 Na. 2 hydrogen, yes, here also 2 hydrogen. Okay, now see here, say for balancing the reaction here, 2 Na, 2 Na, yes, oxygens are 2. So for this we will discuss example K plus H2O, that gives what? KOH plus H2. Okay, so we have to balance this reaction. H2, here also 2. So we can cross check our. Now see here, 2K, here also 2K. 2 hydrogen, yes, here also. How much? Yes, 2 hydrogen, this 2. Okay, here also 4 hydrogen, here also 4. Means our reaction is balanced. Means whatever your potassium metal, when it reacts with H2, it gives what? Potassium hydroxide plus H2 gas. Means here H2 gas is evolved. H2 gas is evolved. Understood? So, see here our next. But one thing here you keep in mind. We can observe it here calcium also. So, see Ca plus H2O. So, what they are giving us? Calcium hydroxide plus H2. Okay, so for balancing the reaction, take here 2. So say one calcium, 2 hydrogen. Yes, here also 2 hydrogen, and these 2 4 hydrogen. Okay, and our reaction is balanced. Means one of the most important thing here is what? Whatever your sodium, potassium, they react vigorously with water. Sodium, potassium, calcium, they are react vigorously with water and with evolution of what? H2 gas. And that H2 gas catches fire easily. That H2 gas here catches fire easily. Whereas, if you are doing calcium and magnesium, okay, so basically these two most important, okay, so sorry for that calcium, these two, whatever your sodium and potassium. Okay, so see, your these two, sodium and potassium, these are react vigorously with water and with evolution of what? H2 gas. And that H2 gas catches the fire easily. Understood? And this calcium, so very much interesting thing about this calcium and magnesium. So see that what it is. We can write with statement. Okay, so calcium and magnesium. Calcium and magnesium floats on water. Floats on water. So why there floats on water? Because bubbles of hydrogen gas form during reaction with water, okay, during reaction with water, stick to the surface of calcium and magnesium. Okay, so very much important this thing here. When calcium, why they are calcium and magnesium? Okay, they are forming hydroxides along with H2 gas. Okay, but here what? Calcium and magnesium floats on water because bubbles of hydrogen gas form during the reaction with water, stuck to the surface of calcium and magnesium. That's why it floats over water. That's why it floats over water. This thing you keep in mind. We can observe this in chemistry lab also, and we will observe. Don't worry. Okay. So these are what basic things about your, yes, calcium and magnesium. And as you know, sodium and your potassium, these are what? Yes, highly reactive. And with the water, it gives what? Exothermic reaction. And whatever hydrogen gas evolved, it catches a fire also. Okay, so we will move towards second. We will discuss reaction of magnesium metal with water. So see here, normally it will react with what? Your magnesium with hot water, H2O, but that what? Hot water. Okay, hot water. So you will get what here? Yes, MgOH twice plus H2. MgOH twice plus H2. So see here, we have to balance this reaction. Here 2, so 4. Here 2, this 2, 4, and 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen. Okay, but your magnesium reacts with steam also. Okay, H2O is in the form of what? Steam. But at that time, what you will get? Your magnesium oxide plus H2 gas. Plus what? H2O gas. Okay, so these are what? Reaction with Mg. Reaction of magnesium with water. Okay, so we will discuss next. That is reaction of zinc. Okay, understood this thing. And you have to balance also. Now we will discuss next. Reaction of zinc. Reaction of zinc with water. Okay, so you have to concentrate on whatever water it is, hot or whatever cold. So basically, whatever sodium and potassium, they will react with cold water at room temperature. But here what? Your magnesium reacts with what? Hot water and steam water. But with hot water, they are giving what? Hydroxide. And with steam, they are giving what? Oxides. Understood? You have to keep in mind this difference. Okay. So we will see reaction of zinc with water. So zinc also does not easily react with water. So for that, we have to what? Steam. So zinc plus H2O. Steam. Yes, what they are giving? ZnO plus H2. Zinc oxide plus H2. Okay. So very much important is here. And fourth, this is what your third. Okay. Then we will discuss here fourth also. So that fourth is what? See here. That fourth reaction. Reaction of iron with water. So in that, basically iron also, it will not react with the normal water, cold water, hot water. It will react only with what? Steam. So see, your iron plus H2O, okay, it is in the form of what? Steam. So it gives what? Iron, Fe3O4 plus H2. So it is this Fe3O4 is what? It is a combination of FeO dot Fe2O3. Understood? Magnetite. What you call it is what? Magnetite. And it is a ore of what? Your iron. Understood? So we have to balance this reaction. So see here 4 oxygen. So here also 4 oxygen must. 8 hydrogen. Sorry, here 8. Yes, 8 hydrogen. So here 4. Understood? So 3 Fe. So see, once again we will cross check. 3 Fe, 3 Fe. Okay, 4 oxygen, 8 hydrogen, 8 hydrogen. Okay, so it will gas here evolve. Understood? So like that here, so many important all those reactions. Okay. So you have to keep in mind all these reactions. And whatever your doubts, you can share. Okay. So here one of the most important term here, that is what? Magnesium reacts with hot water. Okay. Whereas magnesium reacts with hot water. Whereas whatever your aluminium, then zinc, then iron, it reacts with what? Steam to form their respective oxides. Okay, now only we saw that. So we can write here reactivity order also. So see, reactivity order as like this. Reactivity order. So see, first which one will come? Mg, then Al, then zinc, then your what? Iron. Understood? So it is what? Reactivity order towards the water. Okay, so very much important is reactivity order. You have to keep in mind this. Okay, it will react with hot water, then it starting with what? With a steam. Understood? So you have to keep in mind. So other metals, such as metals like your copper, then gold, then your silver, tin also, it does not react with your steam also. Okay, so very much reacts with, even at high temperature also, it will not react. Okay, so final order we can write here. Okay, so final order, reactivity order with respect to our highly reactive metal also. So say potassium, then sodium, okay, then what will come? Your calcium, then magnesium, then aluminium, zinc, and last what? Your iron. Okay, So you have to keep in mind this final reactivity order also with respect to highly reactive metal. Okay, and suppose you have to write for magnesium. With respect to magnesium, then this reactivity also important. Okay, so these are what our reaction with reaction with water of different metals. Okay, so whatever our next part, okay, so whatever our next part we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you. So keep revising all you that whatever we taught, anodizing base metal. Okay, thank you.